हैव स्टडीड अबाउट ऑसिलेशंस एंड व्हाट इज पीरियोडिक मोशन, व्हाट इज पीरियोडिक फंक्शन एंड व्हाट इज ऑसिलेटरी मोशन. एंड इवन इन दैट सेक्शन वी हैव सीन दैट एवरी ऑसिलेटरी मोशन कैन बी पीरियोडिक, बट एवरी पीरियोडिक मोशन मे बी ऑसिलेटरी. एंड मीन्स देर इज नो कंडीशन अपॉन द पीरियोडिक मोशन टू बी ऑसिलेटरी. एंड एज यू नो दैट पीरियोडिक मोशन इज दैट इन विच मोशन रिपीट इट सेल्फ आफ्टर अ सर्टेन इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम और आफ्टर अ फिक्सड इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. मीन्स आफ्टर दैट फिक्सड इंटरवल द मोशन रिपीट्स इट सेल्फ द ऑल ऑफ द वैल्यूज ऑफ द मोशन दैट विल बी इक्वल टू द इनिशियल वैल्यूज. सो एट दैट कंडीशन आई थिंक ऑसिलेटरी मोशंस आर सिंपली दैट इज क्लियर टू यू. एंड वॉट इज पीरियोडिक फंक्शन दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट. एंड वॉट इज हार्मोनिक वेव्स, एक्चुअली इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल सी द ऑसिलेशंस इन केस ऑफ हार्मोनिक मोशन ओनली. एंड द हार्मोनिक मोशन इज वन इन विच वी टेक द टेक्नोमेट्रिकल फंक्शन टू डिस्क्राइब द मोशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल, एनी ऑसिलेटिंग पार्टिकल. सपोज दैट एनी पार्टिकल दैट इज ऑसिलेटिंग एंड वी आर सीइंग दैट द इक्वेशन ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट इक्वेशन दैट इज ऑब्टेन्ड इट कंटेन्स द साइन फंक्शन और कोसाइन फंक्शन और अदर टेक्नोमेट्रिकल फंक्शन, देन इन दैट दैट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑसिलेटरी मोशंस आर नोन एज हार्मोनिक मोशंस. सो बेसिकली हार्मोनिक मोशंस वी विल स्टडी एंड देयर वी हैव टू टेक बेसिक साइन और कोसाइन फंक्शंस दैट आर एनफ टू एक्चुअली एक्सप्लेन दिस. सो वी कैन टेक आइदर साइन फंक्शन और कोसाइन फंक्शन, दैट इज डिपेंड्स ऑन यू totally than what ever you want to choose. If suppose that at t equal to 0 y is equal to 0 then the function will be sine, and if at t is equal to 0 then there will be the maximum value or amplitude is obtained then the functions will be cosine. So I think there is no confusion, you know already the graphs about the cosine or sine functions. So here today we have to see, as we have seen when I was deriving a concept when two periodic motions are superimposed over each other, mix each other, then whether their resultant is periodic or not. So we have seen that if two periodic functions are of same frequency, same angular frequency they have, then they will be periodic after mixing, after superposition, and that periodic function will have the different resultant amplitude and different resultant phase. So here one word that is the phase. So today let's see what is phase and what is the importance of phase or knowledge, what is the importance of the knowledge about the phase. So phase is nothing but it is a physical quantity which describes the motion and direction of a particle at any instant in the motion. Suppose that if we want to calculate in which direction our particle is oscillating or that is moving, and also what is the position at that point. So that position and direction means if we have knowledge about the direction then we can also calculate the position of the particle. So the basic very important factor that the phase tells us that is the direction of motion, means in which direction the particle is moving on. So simple phase tells us about the position of the particle and direction of the particle at any instant in the motion. So I think there is no confusion what is the phase represent. Normally how can we tell that a particle is in which direction? We assign that with the help of theta, with the help of angle. We are seeing that in which direction it is making the angle, and with the help of that angle we will able to say that in which quadrant the particle is moving or in which plane it is moving and at which angle it is moving. So simple the phase tells us the same things like we calculate the direction of the particle in transitory motion. Next is that how can we measure the phase of the particle. Simple, it is measured in fraction of time period, or simple as you know that in case of periodic sun we have 2 pi that is the period of oscillation. So we can say that it is a fraction of 2 pi. Simple, if we want to measure the phase difference then we can measure in fraction of 2 pi or in terms of in fraction of time interval, time period. what is as we have to study about harmonic motions. Harmonic motions in which sine or cosine functions or trigonometrical functions are used. So in case of harmonic motion, we can calculate very easily what is the phase of the that motion. So it can be calculated with the augment of sine or cosine function. So if we will calculate easily augment of the sine and cosine function, that augment will be phase of the system. So that is very easy method. Suppose that we have equation that is y is equal to a sine omega t plus theta 0 something. So here we are seeing that the augment of sine, that is total this value omega t plus theta 0. So here what will be the phase of the oscillation? That will be omega t plus theta 0. Simple, it's very simple. When there is harmonic oscillation, then in case of harmonic oscillation, phase of the motion, that is augment of a simple sine or cosine or other functions which are we are using. So simple, what will be the phase? It can be denoted by phi. So this is equal to omega t plus theta 0, or we can also write in place of omega 2 pi by t plus theta 0. So the question, as I have told you, that we can take it the fraction of time period, so we can take it from here. And also phase relates the direction, means in which direction the particle is moving. If this theta 0 is 0, it means that particle is started from origin and it is moving like that. The theta 0 has some values, it tells us about directions and other things. So let's see how can we calculate the, if suppose that two waves are moving, so we can, how can we calculate the phase difference between them? And also if we have two vibrating particles, suppose that, so if there are two vibrating particles, then we can also test that in which direction the harmony is lacking on. Means the one wave can have a greater harmony, second wave can have, so second oscillation can have less harmony. So we can also compare their harmony, and also we can say that first wave is going ahead or second wave is lacking. Means such types of leading and lacking things we can also, means we can compare two oscillations easily with the knowledge of phase difference. So let's see how can we compare them with the knowledge of phase difference. So first let's see that suppose that the mean position is two vibrating particles are at any instant t, their mean positions are same. Means if they are reaching to its equilibrium point, to its mean point at the same time, and also their directions are same. Suppose if any bob is that is moving, and here the second bob is also moving, means if two bobs are moving and oscillating, means and they are, if this one is going in this direction, then this one is also going in this direction. So here direction is same, and also if they reaches to this mean position, so they reach at the same time. If then so what will be the condition, how can we calculate phase difference in such types of motion? In terms of harmonic wave, we can show it. Suppose that this is a wave A. And this is second wave. So this is wave, this is vibrating particle A, this is vibrating particle B. As you are seeing that they have both have same directions, means if one is moving in positive x y direction, then the other is also moving in positive y direction. If second is moving in negative y direction, then first is also moving in negative y direction. So direction is same, and also the mean position, the time of mean position, that is also the same. So in this condition, the phase difference between the particles, that will be zero. There is no phase relationship between these particles. So if we want to calculate, suppose that here the phase is phi 1, here the phase is phi 2. So we can calculate the difference, that is phi 1 minus phi 2. that will be equal to 0. So the first case is when the mean position and direction of propagation, that both are same for the two vibrating particles, then the phase difference between them, that will be 0. The second case, can be, suppose that if both the vibrating particles are reaching to equilibrium point mean position at the same time, and but they are opposite in direction, means they are propagating oppositely. Suppose if one wave is moving in y direction, the positive y direction, the other is moving in the same time and in negative y direction, but they are reaching to the mean position in the same time. Suppose that if you can take the example of bob here, also a pendulum. Suppose if one particle is moving, vibrating in this direction, and at the same time if the second bob is here, then this one is moving in opposite direction. So if such types of vibrations, and when it returns to this point, it returns to this point, then they meet at the this point, equilibrium point, at the same time. So that's why mean position is same, time of mean position is same, but the direction is opposite. We can also show this with the help of sine wave. Suppose this is wave A. This is B. So as you are seeing that the mean positions for A and B, that is same in both the cases, and also the direction of propagation here is just opposite, in opposite direction. So in this condition, the phase difference, that is equal to 180 degrees, or in case of radian, if you want to write it, then this will be pi radians. So this is the phase difference when they are moving in opposite direction. We can write also the equation for these. Like suppose that if one wave, that is it is starting from this point, we can write it here, pi is equal to a sine omega t, and y1 is equal to, and y2 is equal to, suppose the amplitudes are different for two waves, so y2 equal to b sine omega t plus y. So we can write the equation, displacement equation for two particles if we know the phase relationship between them, means in which directions they are moving. If we know about that, then we can easily write the displacement equations for them in such a manner. We have to only add the phase difference in one of the waves. Let's say the third condition. In third condition, suppose that mean positions are different, means they are reaching, means at the same time, one is at mean position and other is not at mean positions, means their own mean positions are different. And also suppose that first wave is ahead of second wave. So that's why in that condition, what will be the phase difference? Suppose such types of wave we have like this, and one is suppose something like this. So if there are two waves, this is A, this is B, this time this is displacement. So in this condition, as you are seeing that the waves, the wave A is ahead of B, and also their mean positions are different, means they are not meeting at the same time. Then in such conditions, as this is the maximum amplitude obtained, and in case of harmonic waves, it is pi by 2. So here the phase difference between the waves in this case, this is pi by 2. So if we know the phase difference between them, then we can write also the equation of displacement equation for this vibrating particle. So for A particle, as it is ahead of pi by 2, then y1 will be A sine omega t plus pi by 2. And for the second wave particle, this is B sine omega. So in the first particle, there is both of the particles there are pi by 2 phase difference, that is. Actually, by these examples, I just want to tell you, if we know the phase relationship between any two particles, then we can also tell their positions. As I am telling you that with the help of phase relationship, I am explaining the position of the particle. So simple, we can tell the direction and position both of the particles with the help of phased knowledge of phase. So phase tells us that very important property of the oscillating particles. So this topic is also very important. So the next condition is that if also mean positions for the particle is not same, and also suppose that if a particle is lacking and b is ahead by pi by 4 such types. So what will be in their case? This is a very general case actually. Suppose this is A and this is the position of, this is B. So this is B, this is A. So in this sense we are seeing that also the mean positions are not same, and also it is B is lacking, not anything. B is lacking the pi by 4 than the A. So we can write the phase difference here, that will be pi by 4 radian or 45 degree. And also we can write the displacement equation for one wave as it is started from origin. So y1 will be a sine omega t, and for the second wave as it is lacking pi by 4, so here will be b sine omega t minus pi by 4. So if particles are ahead than B, then here will be plus, and if it is lacking, then it will be minus. So I think while writing the displacement equations with the help of phase difference, phase relationship between any two vibrating particles, there is no confusion to all of you. How can we calculate it? How can we keep it? So if I think this topic is clear to you, how can we tell the position and with the direction of the particles with the help of phase difference. So the next topic is free oscillation and simple harmonic motion. I think there is now no confusion regarding to the basic factors like what is amplitude, what is time period, what is displacement, what is phase, what is periodic function, what is periodic motion, what is oscillatory waves, oscillations and oscillatory motion. I think all the basic things now regarding to oscillation, that is all in your mind. So let's start the main topics of the chapter, that is the harmonic motions. And here we have to study about the number of harmonic motions. Like suppose that if any particle is executing oscillation or vibratory motions, and it is doing the harmonic vibratory motion or harmonic oscillation, then what will be the displacement in that case, and how can we prove it? What will be the velocity of the particle? What will be the acceleration of the particle? What at any time, what will be the kinetic energy or potential energy of the particle or total energy of the particle? So we can all calculate it very easily. And first, while calculating it, like we have done some suppositions in case of gases. In case of ideal and real gas, when we were studying, then first we study about the ideal gas. Why we have to do it? Because in case of ideal gas, we have the kinetic theory, where we have made some assumptions on the gases mediums. Like we have taken some limitations for masses and also for attractive forces, and with the help of that limitations, easily our complications have been reduced, and due to that we were able to solve it for number of thermodynamic processes, and also we have seen number of laws about that, and we can easily calculate that. And after, when we have to study about the real gases, then with the help of only some modifications we can study that. Or with in comparison to ideal gas, real gas behavior can be studied. So in the that's why we always try to first take the ideal conditions, because that ideal conditions contains some limitations, some assumptions, and these were assumptions which were making some problems or complex. We feel some here that complex problems due to that assumption. So that's why we assume that and we neglect them in the case of ideal processes. So about that, we will be able to easily study about the system. So in case of oscillations, we do the same process. First, as you know that you have seen that when we displace any ball from its mean position and we leave when released it, and after that some time we have seen that it stops. So why it is stopped? As we have already know that here the frictional force, viscosity of air is working on that, and in that condition its energy loses continuously, and that's why it is stopped purely. So that type of motion is known as damped harmonic motion. So this types of motion we have, and the study of that types of motion is quite complicated. So because there is a presence of external forces that are reducing, that are retarding the motion. So first we see the case where no retarding force are there, only whatever external force we are applying the system on the system, that is only that will be applicable. We have to assume that there is no retarding force, no resistance force in the path of the oscillatory particle. So such types of motions are known as simple harmonic motion, or simply as we are talking about the harmonic motion, so that's why its name is simple harmonic motion. So first before starting it, let's see what is free oscillations. So as by name it is clear that something may be some factors should be free from here. So as I am talking about that, there the frictional means there are number of resistive forces that are acting in nature that reduces the velocity of oscillating particles. That's why finally the oscillating particles get stopped. And suppose if there are such types of oscillatory motion in which no resistive force is present, means no frictional force, no viscosity, nothing is present in that, if we displace once the particles from its mean position, equilibrium position, then for infinite time it will oscillate with the same frequency, with the same amplitude. Means its amplitude will never be changed, and it will continue with not its time period, no amplitude, not frequency, nothing will change. It will be constant in nature, because as we are assuming that there is no resistive force acting on it which can retard the motion of these oscillatory particles. So that's why the free oscillations are those types of motions. Means simple, in free oscillations no resistive force, no retarding force will present in the medium of oscillation here. And if any particle executing harmonic motion in the with free oscillations, then that type of harmonic motion is known as simple harmonic motion. So simply in case of simple harmonic motion, there is no retarding force that present that can retard the motion. So once if we displace it, it will continue its motion until we will stop it. Means it follows totally the Newton's first law. Means if there is no retarding force, then for infinite time, if there is no external force is applying on it, then its motion will continue. Means only in one is displacing for one time, we can get the energy for infinite time from such types of oscillators. So first, how can we define the or how can we formulate the formula for simple harmonic motion? So as you are saying that here this equation, and suppose that if this is a bob and this is hang from a liquid surface and we are displacing this particle, obviously if we are displacing then we are applying an external force, and obviously due to inertia the energy of the particle that will oppose the application of this force or oppose the motion of the force. So obviously particle will have tendency to come to its equilibrium position, come to its stable position. So there will be the negative relationship between these, means greater will be the force, greater will be the displacement, means but in opposite direction. So first the force that is act is directly proportional to minus of x. Minus sign only denotes that force and the displacements are in opposite direction. We are applying force in this direction, but this particle will have always tendency to come to its original position, equilibrium position. So that's why there will be minus sign. And also there is a force acting. We can solve it very easily with the help of Newton's second law. So what will be the value of it? So if we solve it, that is equal to some constant K, that is known as force constant. So this is equation number first. And from Newton's second law of motion, we can write a equation for this, F into ma, that is. So since there is some displacement, and due to that displacement there will be some velocity, and also due to that there will be some acceleration in the motion. So that we can write this formula and we simply equate these two equations as the force is same. So what will be K? M d2x upon dt2, that will be equal to minus kx of plus Ex, that will be equal to 0, or we can write d2x upon dt2 plus k by m x, that will be equal to 0. Or we can write d2x upon dt2 plus omega 0 square x is equal to 0. Where omega 0 is equal to, we have put omega 0 square in place of k by m. So what will be the value of omega 0? That is root k by m. This is the angular frequency of the oscillation. Omega 0 means with initial what means we ask that to, with which initial frequency that is oscillating. So this is the initial angular frequency with which the particle is executing simple harmonic motion. But also it will be constant, as in case of simple harmonic motion we are taking that there is no retarding force, so definitely that will be constant. As this equation contains the differential form, you are seeing that ddt form it is containing, that is, this is known as differential form of, this is the differentiation of second order. So if this equation contains the differential form, then such types of equations are known as differential equation of simple harmonic motion. So this is differential equation of simple harmonic motion. And if we solve it by mathematical methods, then we obtain the value of x, that is obtained as A sine omega t. If suppose that if there are some fail, then you can write it A sin omega t plus phi. So this is very simple explanation of this is the equation of simple harmonic motion. Clear? So finally this for simple harmonic motions we have calculated very easy what is the differential equation and what is the equation of, this is the displacement equation of simple harmonic motion. And we can prove it very easily by the concept of the simple harmonic oscillations. This is the angular frequency of the oscillation. And now we have the value of x, value of displacement. Then obviously if we differentiate it with respect to time, then we can calculate what will be the velocity of oscillation. And again if we take it two times, differentiate it, then we can get acceleration. So with the all of the quantity can be observed easily with the help of this displacement equation. So first we need to always formulate this displacement equation, and this is very helpful to understand the other properties of such types of simple harmonic motions. So now I think about everything about free oscillation and simple harmonic motion, whatever I have explained you here, that is all clear to you. How can we formulate these formulas, and this can be asked with to you in the examination, and also in daily life you can understand it very easily. And in terms, as you are seeing that this is the omega frequency of oscillator, and you can write it here omega 0, because the frequency will be constant in this way in the case of simple harmonic motion, and there are no retarding force present in the medium. So these factors are clear. Then in next class we will see that what is the graphical representation of simple harmonic motion, what will be the velocity, what will the acceleration, other all values you will see in the next class. So for today, let's end the